In this video, we will explore roof editing possibilities available within Pro Features of Live Home 3D. Our example is based on one of the templates which can be found in the sample house section of the project gallery. As you can see, the house has several complicated roofs located on different levels. By the end of this lesson, it will no longer be a mystery how to create them. When working with such roofs, it is always better to start with the upper floor roof. Here's what we should do. Using the Building Properties tab of the inspector, switch to the upper story, which is the second floor in this case. In the project tree, or on 2D plan, select all walls on the current story. Change wall type to loft walls in the Objects Property tab of the inspector. Switch back to Buildings Property tab and add AutoRoof on the current story. Choose the hip roof in the dialog that appears. Now switch to the 3D view and select all the segments of the roof you wish to modify. In our case, we select 5 segments. With the help of the inspector, change the type of roof segments to gable. The angle of the remaining slope type segments of the roof should be set to 25 degrees. Now let's switch to the first floor. And again, as we did before, select all walls and change them to loft type. Add a roof above using the rectangular roof tool in 2D. This time in the roof template dialog, choose shed roof type. Use the rotate roof button to give the roof correct orientation. As you can see, the roof we created and the roof above do not coincide. Here's what we should do to fix that. Using the inspector, set the angle of the lower roof slope to 25 degrees. Raise the roof by setting the appropriate elevation. Looks pretty neat to me. Now we should hide unnecessary elements. In the project tree, change all gable type roof segments to hole type segments. Well, it's about time to add a dormer with the help of the technique described in the Using Contour Points for Making Roofs video. Select the necessary roof contour and add 4 points to it. Move 2 inner points ahead, 50 millimeters will do, and place them in front of 2 remaining points. This will create a segment like this on the roof. Select it and change its type to hole. We'll get something like this. Using the same technique, we add a roof here. Again, activate the rectangular roof tool and draw a roof above the balcony contour. Choose gable roof type and rotate it if necessary. Set the roof elevation and, of course, the slope angle to 25 degrees. Hide unnecessary elements. In the project tree, change all gable type roof segments to hole type segments. Here's what we get in the end. The time has come to add a roof above the garage. The steps are the same as with the first floor. First, we add a shed roof above. Then we rotate it and add a dormer with the help of the contour editing technique. The next element we add is the front door awning. Making one is quite simple. Create a roof in 2D. Select shed type of roof and rotate it. Set the necessary elevation and roof angle. We'll set the slope angle to 15 degrees this time. Creating a porch shed will require slightly more time. First, we need to add a hip roof above the porch. Then one of its segments adjacent to a wall should be selected and its type changed to hole. Looks like all roofs are in place. All we need to do now is to apply necessary materials to all roof segments and add, where necessary, windows from the object library. Something like that we should get in the end. Using techniques described above, you can create virtually any roof in Live Home 3D Pro.